Hello everyone. In this session, or today we start the chapter number 3, that is overview of transformations. In this chapter, basically the graphic system must allow the user to change the way the object appears. Okay. In this overview of transformation chapter, we learn this concept, that is first one is two-dimensional transformation. In that we learn about translation, scaling, rotation, reflection and sharing the objects. By using two-dimensional and three-dimensional, we always translate, scaling, rotation and reflection and sharing the object. The translation means, translation is the process of changing the positions of an object in a straight line path from one coordinate location to another. Means we have translated the object from one position to the another position. Then second one is scaling. Scaling means to change the size of the object. Then third one is the rotation. In the rotation, suppose a 2D rotation is applied to an object by repositioning it along a circular path in a XY plane. In this rotation, we rotate the object in a XY plane. Okay. Then next one is the reflection. The reflection means is the mirror image of original object. In other words, we can say that it is a rotation operation with 180 degree. Then next one is the sharing. Sharing means a transformation that slants the shape of an object is called as shared transformation. In sharing, we slant the object from its original shape. Okay. Then next, that is 3.2, is matrix representation. In matrix representation, in that design and picture formation process, many times we may require to perform the translation, rotation, scaling to fit the picture component into their proper position. So to fit the object in a proper position, we require or we perform the translation, rotation, scaling by using matrix. Okay. So matrix is used to which purpose? To change the object or change an image can be easily, we can change the object by using the matrix. Okay. Then in that a matrix representation, in that translation, scaling, rotation, reflection and sharing is done by using the matrix representation. Okay. The next one is 3.3 is composite transformation. Composite transformation means it combines two objects. The next, in that the rotation about an arbitrary object or of arbitrary point means to rotate an object about an arbitrary point x, y, we have to carry out same step. Okay. By using some step, we rotate the object about an arbitrary point, that is x, y coordinate points. Then next one is the 3.4, that is three-dimensional transformation. In a three-dimensional transformation, in that manipulating and viewing and construction of 3D graphics image require the use of 3D geometric and coordinate transformations. In a three-dimensional transformation, in that we have to manipulate viewing and construction of 3D object image requires the use of the 3D geometric and coordinate transformation. Okay. In the 3D transformation is used in that concept is translation, scaling and rotation concept is there. The next point is 3.5, that is types of projections. In type of projection, in that after converting a object from old coordinate to the new coordinate, to viewing the coordinate we can project the 3D object onto the 2D view plane. Okay, means we have to project a 3D plane into 2D plane object. Okay, so this concept is in a 3.5 point. Okay, then after completion of this chapter we will able to get some unit outcomes. This one is the unit outcome. The first unit outcome is perform the given operation in 2D transformations. Second one, perform the given operation in 3D transformation. Third, solve the given problem based on composite transformations. And last one, apply the given type of projection on object. So this is our unit outcome. Okay. Here is the second unit, that is overview of transformation. In the real world, we frequently rearrange objects or look at them from different angles. We can change the size of an object, its position on the screen, or its orientation. Okay, so in this chapter, we can change the size of an object, its position on the screen, or its orientation. Okay, so our computer graphics images are generated from a series of line segments which are represented by the coordinates of their endpoints. Certain changes in an image can be easily made by performing mathematical operations on these coordinates. So we can change the size, or we can change the orientation or position of an object. We require some mathematical operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, transpose, etc. And this operation is used in a matrix. Before we go in detail of various transformation, let us review some of the mathematical tools we shall need, namely matrix multiplication, transformation and matrices. In computer graphics, images are generated from a series of the line segments which are represented by the coordinates of their endpoints. In computer graphics, the images are generated from a line segment, and this line segment are represented by the coordinates of their endpoints, that is x and y coordinates. x1 y1 and x2 y2. Okay, due to this we can make change in an image by performing mathematical operations. As I say, the mathematical operations are required to change the image on our screen. Okay, or position a image, position a object, change the position of an object with the help of coordinates. When we change the image, we call image is transformed. This is a matrix. So a matrix, we know that the matrix is a two-dimensional array of number. This is the 2 into 2, that is 2 row and 2 column. This is the 1 matrix, that is 1 column. In this matrix, this is a 3 by 3 matrix, means 3 row and 3 column is there. These are the 3 different matrices, is 2 by 2, 3 by 3 and only 1 column. Okay, so matrix multiplication. In a matrix is an array of numbers. In this matrix we see that here is a 2 rows and 3 columns, that is this 2 rows and 3 columns. Scalar, the next point is the scalar multiplication. So scalar multiplication means to multiply a matrix by a single number called a scalar. Means we multiply a matrix in a single number is called as a scalar multiplication. This is the scalar multiplication. In this we see that this one is a single number and we multiply this matrix to a single number is equal to, this one is the our answer, that is 2 into 4 8, 2 into 0 0, 2 into 1 2, 2 into -9, that is -18. Then next point is the multiplying a matrix by another matrix. To multiply a matrix by another matrix, we need to do the dot product of rows and columns. Consider this example. This is the 2 by 3 matrix, that is 2 row and 3 columns. And we multiply this matrix into this one, that is 3 by 2, means 3 row and 2 column. So firstly, we multiply the first row in a first matrix to a first column in a second matrix, that is 1, 2, 3 into 7, 9, 11. Means we multiply 1 into 7 plus 2 into 9 plus 3 into 11 is equal to, 1 into 7 is equal to 7, 2 into 9 is equal to 18 and 3 into 11 is equal to 33. And we get the result is equal to 58. So the answer is the 58. Then we multiply the first row in a first matrix is multiply the second column in a second matrix, that is 1, 2, 3 into 8, 10, 12. 1 into 8, 2 into 10 and 3 into 12. The result is 1 into 8 is equal to 8 plus 2 into 10 is equal to 20, 3 into 12 it is equal to 36. And we sum of these results, we get the answer is 64. and put the answer is here. Then the next step is second row and first column. Means we multiply the second row in a first matrix is multiplied to first column in a second matrix, that is 4, 5, 6 into 7, 9, 11. 4, 5, 6 is multiplied into 7, 9, 11. That is 4 is multiplied into 7 plus 5 is multiplied into 9 plus 6 into 11. The result is 139, and this result is put into here. Then the last one is we multiply the second row into first matrix into second column in a second matrix, that is 4, 5, 6 into 8, 10 and 12. So is equal to, the result is 4 into 8 plus 5 into 10 plus 6 into 12, and the result is 154, and this result is put into here, and we get some resultant matrix, that is 58, 64, 139, that is 139 and 154, and this matrix is 2x2 matrix. Okay, so in this matrix multiplication, we multiply the matrix in a 3x3 into 2x2, 3x2 into 2x3 by using these procedures. Okay, so in this session only we learned about the matrix and the matrix multiplications. So by using matrix, we rotate, we change the position, the object into another position. Okay, in the next session we learn the next point, that is scaling, rotation and so on. Thank you so much for listening this session. Thank you.